Okay, that was odd. I don't know what cut me off there. Better keep a good eye on OBS to see if it's acting up at all. Yes. We're on the eve of war. But I've got a cunning plan. I'm going to ally Normandy. I might as well take the mission to claim Abenaki. Who can argue with 25 free military points? Now, let's chase down that Breton fleet. Where could they be? Aha. Snaking their way up. Come a little closer. Okay, 3rd of February, that's just a couple days away. Okay, I got you. I keep it as a revolutionary war, so Russia cannot become war leader. And Normandy won't join in, unfortunately. And straight off the bat, I can sink some of the enemy fleets. Oh. He won't join in. He would if I had this guy, though. There we go, that got Normandy in on the war. More important than it might seem. I've got my spare colonist kept just for this moment, so I can steal that colony. 1,000 should suffice. While I'm doing all this, there's something else I want to do. I'm actually gonna sack Fernando. You done good, but just not good enough. I want an explorer. And I want 2 light ships, if I even have that. Yeah. I'd rather not take the light ship from there. That'll do. Dismiss the cog. And get... oh, jeez. Yeah, forget you guys. I got good ships down here for the task. Onwards. I want to try exploring my way so I can see the how Russia's getting on across the pond. Man, I can't take chat this fast. What's it say? Could you do the same exploit that you did with the Aztecs, giving you infinite monies? No, and I'll show you why. Take Basaganola, for example. If I wanted to send them subsidies, it would say no because they're a subject nation. Can't give subsidies to subject nations anymore. It doesn't matter who's subject nation. Even the Ethiopia couldn't give it to them because they're subject to the Ottomans. Seems like a bit of a sloppy patch, but whatever works. Huh, you join this war. But I don't need you on my side here. Okay, that's less of a fleet to worry about. No need to get cocky though, just keeping my ships here to pounce on anything that gets in my way. Get military access from you. I'll go up to deal with these filthy Bretons. Normally I like Bretons, but I have to be cautious. They've taken exploration ideas, and that is unacceptable. Mine. 197 settlers. Should keep an eye on that, but it should be okay. Oh, okay. That's not good at all. But it's retreating through Terra Incognita to where I need it to go. Well, don't that beat all? Right, that takes care of Breton matters. I'm going to send our good friends Normandy a little gift, just something to help tide them along. What is more, I'm going to send them a little gift of men as well. I'm doing the 12th. I'm going to attach to their unit. Hopefully they make use of that. Said attach. I wonder if he's a little confused. Oh, I don't have military access to France, so I can't help him out there. That'll be why. Well, I'm not even slightly concerned. Got lands to explore here. Hopefully that's not too far from my ships. I don't want that explorer to die, but he should be okay. Culturally and religiously, the British Isles are getting better and better. Converting to London's going to be a pain, but oh. I don't want to deny the glory of Foix, but oh, that's nice. I'm helping out. I'll fight in the water. Ho-hum, ho-hum. Let's explore a bit. I should keep my eye on this seaboard. I also need to occupy a fair few of these Norwegian provinces. I want to try and strip Norway of these islands so that they don't have the colonial range to further annoy me. That's only fair. Well, they're getting straight at it. I'm trying to take Epiquick. What were those rebels in Picardy or Champagne? Not sure, but Flanders decided to gobble them up. Also, Flanders has taken care of my only other colonial rival, the Netherlands. They even have exploration ideas, they haven't colonized anything. I know Holland takes them eventually, but they haven't taken it now. Friesland do as well, but again, they haven't yet. Not a problem. That is. Come on, ships. Don't have all day. Not my cogs! I need those for cogging. Damn, that looks French. That looks disgustingly French. Speaking of disgusting, what's Norway doing with its fleet down here? I'm trying to explore. Even though I'm just fighting lights here, these lights are kind of hurting me. Ah, there we go. That turned the tide. Tide? Sea battle? Beautiful. Jeez, they still have quite a lot of heavies. I should be cautious. And there come the Danish heavies, and the Danish have some damn good ideas to help them out there. Perhaps I should invest in some more. Couldn't hurt, at least. To a stray Norwegian man. Oh, jeez, he's right there. Please, get away. If I just keep all the Danish ships there, it would give me a good opportunity to thrash them once I'm back up to full strength. Still, I've got Carrick. What has he got? He's got naval tradition. Damn Danes. Always getting in my way. That's enough. God, I can't believe the French took the Falklands. How infuriating. Just when I thought I'd finished them off, I'm gonna have to come back for more. Aragon and Friesland take exploration. Well, there ain't no Aragon anymore. Okay, once again, Basque culture proving to be best culture. Turned all those Norwegians Basque just for the presence of one particularly ballsy colonist. My mouse is acting up here. this card is. I'll get more on the go. Says, I bet Norway have some colonies in northern Canada. That would be unfunny. Still, be prudent of me to check. I really don't think my 20 heavies could take on their 11 and 16. But I'm willing enough to try. Well, I'd need better rolls than that. Sinking my ships here. Dangerous. I'm gonna need more heavies. Was a waste of time. I thought I could help out Normandy, but they just wanted to cede the siege to me. Which is not what I want them to do. Okay, so far so good in Canada. So far so good for my explorer. I'm not making any progress here because I do not have naval supremacy over Denmark. Well, at least make a move on Norway. Orkney. Blot out the sun with cogs works every time. Yeah, I'll keep that one in mind then. That's right, I'm so far behind in Diplotech that that's what's really affecting my my Navy's performance. Although I did sink a few Danish ships. Danish lost 3 heavies in that fight. In half a year I'll have my heavies back. Gotta remember though, I'm always losing war score here due to not having their capital. Well, as the war wages on, other nations will get tired and drop out. I actually want Normandy to take Armor, so I told the Pope to attach to me and get off of it. Someone says it might have been better to take the colony as the war goal. Possibly. But I can't worry about that now. Yeah, Norway set up another colony in Canada. We saw that one coming. I saw that they were sending their colonists there. I'll let them build it up for a bit, and I'll steal it later on, because it looks like this war is going to take quite a while. It's a shame I couldn't supremacy at the seas. That you win some, you lose some. And I'd like to win that. Okay, that's nice. On this day, Portuguese was eradicated from the world. There are no Portuguese, only Basque. This is the Iberian culture group. Looking a little lacking there, son. Need some more bicep in your life. Alright, heavies are done. Hopefully it's enough. Hopefully. I would put an admiral, but I know that no admiral I make would be good enough. I understand why they did it, but I don't like the fact that you can only explore one province at a time with your boats. Creature Andrew, welcome to the stream. Asking how Navarra got this big is a bit of a general question. I'm not sure how I'd go about answering it. I annexed Aragon, then Castile, then Portugal, then some of France. That's in the most basic term. Alright, go there, then go home. Switch explorers and get back. Okay, got my heavies. Join up with the other ones. Keep a close eye on them. Come on, Danes. Time for round two. Bring me your best. I said your best! Don't disappoint me, Danes. Danes, how the mighty have sank. Let's get those damaged ships back to port. Now the advantage of the seas is mine. Let's get everyone back to port, actually. How many are we looking at there? 20. Yeah, I can give you a 20 stack. Hold on. Ten cannons and 10 men sounds reasonable, right? Onwards and upwards. DDR Jake decided Basque culture should rule the world. That's precisely how it happened. It doesn't seem I've got much aggressive expansion with anyone that matters. But taking Norwegian lands will probably annoy Denmark. Okay, that's good. Normandy also took Armour. Or is taking Armour. Get on that boat! Oh, no. Don't get on the boat just yet. First, let's take a look at these provinces I'm going to be taking. Fort 2, 2, 2, 2, and a bit more 2. 5 forts. They'll each need 2,000 men. I can split up into 4,000 to be safe. Onwards. Protect them with all of your might. So since I don't think much of interest is going on right now, I've had an idea that I will try to stream another World Conquest, because people keep asking. And I'm not going to say who I'm going to do it as yet, but it's going to be an Asian one province miner. And it's not Ryukyu. I think that stream will start in... well, it'll start when Navarra's finished. And Navarra will be finished when Basque culture is the only culture in Americas, Iberia, and Britain, as well as a chunk of Africa. Just so that the Basque people have a home no matter where they go. as it should be. We want Ryukyu, Ryukyu. No. Been there, done that, got the badge. Okay, once his troops are in position, I can use the rest of my troops to really muscle in on the area. I'll be able to stop Russia from marching in. Well, who can ever really stop Russia? Yeah, Ramazan's in Europe. Besides, I've already done Ramazan, and it was fantastic, but I don't see the need to do the same nation twice. Irish almost completely removed, but let's not be a quitter. Get out of here, Ireland. You're not welcome in my beautiful Basque world. Norwegian colony is growing nicely for me. Okay. Back to Normandy. I think I can trust Bascony not to revolt. Take my troops back up to Normandy. Start taking out the Danish trash. That's a little annoying. To block these straits, it would be just slightly outside of my my supply range. That might change at the end of the month when I core Norfolk, though. Man, these provinces are falling fast. Great. You done good, Enrique. Now I am definitely going to forget about this fleet. So I think I'm just going to give it a fairly general command. So I don't have to keep looking at it, because I'm terrible at managing things across the globe. No! Oh, it's just one of my colonial governors. What should the man of the cold be? Well, I think they're all always going to be diplomatic rulers, just so they can culture convert better. We're okay. Brittany want peace. I'm going to give these two provinces to Navarra. To Normandy. Because Normandy doesn't take exploration ideas. I'm also going to take all their money, because I don't want them to colonize at all. There you go, Normandy. That one's on the house. Instantly cores them, despite the increased coring cost. Sticks down harsh treatment as well. Man, Normandy, you're a nation after my own heart. how we're going to deal with the Danes. Can't ignore all those men I'm going to have to fight if I land in Russia. So the prudent thing would be to take Denmark's capital. Maybe I should wait until I have more troops free before I do that. I really wonder if when Norfolk cores, that'll give me the distance to blockade here. It's only 9 and 13 away. That should be closer, right? Closer than... maybe not. The Count Aberdeen is the closest. Aberdeen's probably closer than Norfolk. Well, you know what? I say go for it anyway. Might be good to have him there, but I don't think he'll be necessary. Alright, let's get a move on. Let's deal with the Danes. Breton haven't got their colonist. That's good. It takes a very long time to mount a naval disembarkment on enemy territory. If there's neutral territory next to them, it's quicker just to disembark there and walk over. Okay, they're taking 1% attrition for now. Okay. The Russian flagships. Certainly don't want to dance with them using only my cogs. I also don't want to dance with those. Please, no, my cogs. I really like those cogs and everything. That's 17 cogs. What are the Russians planning? They're going to try and invade me? What do they take me for? That explorer I sent out. Oh, he's dying. Let's get you home there, buddy Blue. He'll never make it. Try and switch places with the other one. One might make it, but there's no point in taking a risk. I'll combine them and get them back to port. Right. Give me your land, please. My ships are okay. They're not doing too bad. We now know about the world. Most importantly, we know about Russia's expansion. They haven't cored it yet. In fact, God knows why they took that province. And I may have to speed up blocking them off from forming a Russian western coast. I'm not taking Siberia, that would be ugly. I'll be ugly as sin. But I do need to take off this coastline eventually. So much to colonize and so few colonists to do it with. What a curse. Great. With that, I can both dock my ships, just slightly repair, and whenever I put out ships, they're not going to take attrition because it's bordering a province in my control. So I'll keep 10 guys to always keep that one in check. The rest of these guys can go there to help with the sieges. Let's build up some war score through battles and otherwise. I'm going to have to make my move on the Norwegian capital eventually, but for that I'm going to need Russia out of this war. There is a slight possibility that I could just seize some of their colonies, but I really don't want to get involved in Siberia, not at all. B-Dudification says, what about the Spice Islands? Well, my hope for the Spice Islands is that Russia takes them, because I sure don't want them. I will want one of these, but only for East Asian trading modifier. Don't quite think I've got the colonial range to take that, but I'd probably just seize it as a colony. That's only fair. Sorry, Foi, I know you want to be Papal Controller, but it's for your own good that I do it. Excommunicating Denmark seems like overkill. I should save that for France. If if I can remember to do it next time we're at war. Definitely going to need more troops to deal with these guys. But once I get Russia out of the war, and they're very close to leaving... Hell, they'd probably leave for money. If I had a bit more. Someone says, can France colonise now that they have the Falklands? No, the only way France could colonise is if they got a land connection to a coastal province from their capital. And that the whole point of the French wars was to prevent that. So look at that. They lost Picardy, they lost Normandy, I prevented them taking Brittany. Took Poitou, took Bascony, Le Bourde, released Toulouse, released Provence. All to make sure that they don't get their coastal province back. They still have Corps, so I still have to keep France in check. But I will pick them apart and reduce them to, well, Foix, hopefully. I want Foix to take a lot of this. Although I'm taking this land, I've lost almost 20 war score from not having the capital. Which means when I take it, things will swing in my favour quite nicely. I wonder if they're going to westernise off of me. Hope they don't. That'd be a bummer. How did I add extra music into my game? I took the music from Europa 3 and Crusader Kings 2. And I used to have Falalalan as well, but I keep getting rights notifications about that off YouTube, so I stopped. I converted them into OGG files, and... Oh jeez, the Russians. Yeah, I converted them into OGG files and then added a few lines into the songs.txt file inside the songs folder so that it would play them all. Because as great as the music is, a bit of musical diversity is better. I wonder if I can trick the Russians into coming along here. Nah, seems risky. Seems like something I'd forget about and then lose all my troops. That is plenty. How should one deal with the Holy Roman Empire in a world conquest game? Let the Holy Roman Empire form and then annex them. Couldn't be simpler. I actually want that. It's getting on in years, but it's nice to have a 633 in charge again. Let's not take any chances with this colony. Give it just a little bit longer, but I'll try not to forget about it. Denmark going out of the war, can't blame them, but won't let them. Need their war score. Maybe I should let Four have that, but maybe not. Are you sure the computer can deal with the rebel ticks and streaming? That was a really interesting bug, but it went away. It seems that they put a cap on the amount of revolt risk you can have per month to 100%. How generous of them. Come on, Danes, it's not over yet. The moment it touches 900, I'm going to be all over that. Speaking of all over me, I know he's tech 16. But two can play a tech 16 game. I get charge infantry, but I still prefer Mirations. Run, run as fast as you can. You can't beat me, I'm Navara. Thanks for the war score. Time to give me your capital. Catch that might not be my smartest of moves. You know, that was one of Russia's 20-odd stacks. I just need to get Russia out of the war and then I'll be safer. Not to mention his fleet does still slightly scare me. Maybe that's what's keeping them in the war. They still have a good bit of military strength in their navy, but I can't remember where their navy last went. Could chase them down, I suppose, but where are they? Mysterious. Right. Cannot allow these guys any more freedom. Take it for myself. Although Norway can still get events to increase the settlers. So let us take no such chances. Well, that's not good. Seize and send. I don't want any more people joining this bloomin' republic. Wait. Utrecht joins it? Shouldn't they cede? There we go. They did cede to it. Problematic. They probably went to blockade the New World. Not overly surprising. Don't want to pay them loads of money. A simple concession of defeat would be fine. Russia pretty frightening. Right, I wonder, taking this land from Norway, who does it annoy? Other than Norway, I'm not too worried about them. Well, for one, it costs a whole heap of war score. Oh, it's really only Norway and England. Nobody else cares about poor Norway. I gotta break them up with Russia as well, though, so I'm looking at quite a lot of percent. Maybe I should just go balls to the walls on Arkanshus. Do I think I can ally Russia? I wouldn't want to ally Russia. And I tried before, but they rivaled me. Hmm? The Norwegian missionaries that were sent overseas to preach the Norwegian? What? Norwegian? I'll just let them be, because they're about to convert to Protestantism anyway. That was weird. That next idea, but I'll save my administrative points. It's going to be quite expensive to core these Norwegian provinces because they have local nobility. That fantastic idea that everyone loves. Six more cogs for the cog wall. Yeah, well, the colonist has arrived now. It's now Basque and Catholic. And soon it'll belong to Iriots. The trial. This is a horrible one, but I'll see him acquitted.